हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम अंकित एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 23। इन प्रीवियस टू वीडियोस वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अप टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 22। वी आर डिस्कसिंग ए सीरीज ऑफ टॉप 58 क्वेश्चंस इन विच वी विल डिस्कस न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑन ईच कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी एज वेल एज ऑन कंसंट्रेशन टर्म। एंड सेकेंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग सम थियोरेटिकल क्वेश्चन और कंसेप्चुअल क्वेश्चन। ओके, सो विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन नंबर 23। सो टू लिक्विड्स ए एंड बी, लिक्विड ए एंड बी बॉयल्स एट 145 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड 190 डिग्री सेल्सियस। विच ऑफ देम हैज हायर वेपर प्रेशर एट 80 डिग्री सेल्सियस, मीन एट 80 डिग्री सेल्सियस विच विल हैव द हायर वेपर प्रेशर। स्टूडेंट, वॉट इज बॉइलिंग पॉइंट? वैन यू विल हीट अ लिक्विड देन इट्स वेपर विल बी फॉर्म्ड एंड दिस वेपर विल एग्जर्ट द प्रेशर विच इज इक्वल टू द एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर। ओके, इफ ए सब्सटांस हैज लोअर बॉइलिंग पॉइंट, मीन एट लोअर टेम्परेचर इट क्रिएट्स सफिशियंट वेपर प्रेशर। इफ ए सब्सटांस हैज हायर बॉइलिंग पॉइंट इट्स मीन इट नीड्स मोर हीट टू प्रोड्यूस द वेपर विच विल एग्जर्ट द प्रेशर विच इज इक्वल टू 760 ml। So here students, liquid A boils at 145 and liquid B boils at 190, mean it requires more heat to create the vapor pressure 760 and it requires less heat to create the vapor pressure which is equal to 760. It's mean at 80 degree Celsius, mean below its boiling point, it will have higher vapor pressure. Okay, so suppose at 80 degree Celsius it has 500 mm of pressure and second liquid B has 200 mm of pressure. So at 145 degree Celsius, mean on increasing the temperature, definitely these vapor pressure will be equal to the atmospheric pressure very easily. Mean if understand this, vapor pressure is directly proportional to 1 upon boiling point, okay, or you can say inversely proportional, okay. Higher the vapor pressure of a liquid, lesser will be the boiling point, okay. Mean, agar vapor pressure already aapka high hai, 700 hai, aur aapko to phir target 760 karna hai na, it is atmospheric pressure, so you need less heat, is it clear? Okay, question number 24, and student, one more thing, if you have any doubt in any question, in any topic, write in the comment box, I will explain topic again. Okay, I have no problem, but you have to ask. Okay, second question, 24 question is that, based on the solute-solvent interaction, arrange the following in order of increasing solubility in octane. So student, octane is a alkane having the long chain of 8 carbon. Main yahan par 4 kar leta hun. Okay, 4, 5, 4 carbon are these and 5, 6, 7 and 8. Okay, this is octane. So student, octane is a non-polar. Octane is non-polar. Long carbon chain is always non-polar. And we know that like dissolve like. A principle is there, like dissolve like. And according to like dissolve like principle, a solvent will dissolve in that solvent which has the same polarity. Mean if solvent is polar then solute will be dissolved in the polar solvent. Mean polar liquid will be dissolved in polar solvent. Okay, non-polar will be dissolved in non-polar. Okay, if you will try to dissolve polar into non-polar, solubility is not possible. Similarly, if you will try to dissolve non-polar into polar, solubility is not possible. For example, non-polar is oil and polar is water. So can you dissolve oil, mustard oil, into water? You will say no, because mustard oil is non-polar and water is polar. So like dissolve like principle mean polar will dissolve in polar and non-polar component will dissolve in the non-polar. So now, I told you octane is a non-polar. Octane is non-polar. So we have octane as a solvent
एंड वी आर डिजोल्विंग साइक्लोहेक्सेन. सो स्टूडेंट साइक्लोहेक्सेन दिस वन, साइक्लोहेक्सेन ऑल्सो नॉन पोलर. वाई दीज कंपाउंड बोथ ऑक्टेन एंड साइक्लोहेक्सेन आर नॉन पोलर? बिकॉज देयर इज अ बॉन्ड बिटवीन कार्बन एंड कार्बन. ओके, इफ द बॉन्ड बिटवीन टू सिमिलर एटम इज ऑलवेज नॉन पोलर बिकॉज नो वन विल पुल द इलेक्ट्रॉन टुवर्ड्स इट सेल्फ. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एच सी एल इज पोलर बिकॉज क्लोरीन विल विड्रॉ द इलेक्ट्रॉन टुवर्ड्स इट सेल्फ. हाइड्रोजन विल गेट द पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड क्लोरीन विल गेट द नेगेटिव चार्ज. सो देयर इज अ पोलैरिटी. बट इन साइक्लोहेक्सीन बॉन्ड इज इन बिटवीन द कार्बन. ओके, सो दीज कार्बन आर ऑफ सेम इलेक्ट्रॉनिगेटिविटी नेगेटिविटी. नो वन विल विड्रॉ द इलेक्ट्रॉन टुवर्ड्स इट सेल्फ मीन नो कार्बन विल गेट द पॉजिटिव एंड अदर विल नॉट गेट द नेगेटिव. सो इट इज नॉन पोलर. ओके, सिमिलरली इन ऑक्टेन इट इज ऑल्सो नॉन पोलर. सो वट विल हैपन? साइक्लोहेक्सेन विल गेट डिजोल्व इन नॉन पोलर ऑक्टेन वेरी इजली. ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू represent the increasing solubility. So cyclohexane will have the highest solubility. Now come to the least. KCl is ionic, so ionic component will not dissolve in the polar component. So KCl will have the lowest solubility because KCl is highly polar. Okay, because it is ionic compound, so this is polar, even highly polar. So it will not dissolve in the octane. So now what we will do? Now two are left. First is alcohol, second is CH3CN. So student CH3OH and CH3CN. So you will write in the comment box, OH will have the higher polarity or CN have the higher polarity. Okay, this is for your homework. Okay, because already you have studied in class 11th. Okay, so CN is higher polarity means CN is a strong withdrawing group or OH is a strong withdrawing group. So which one will have the higher polarity? You will write here after KCN, and which will have the lowest polarity you will put here. Okay, so you will write the comment, the answer in the comment box. Okay, this is clear. But highest solubility will have the cyclohexane and lowest will have the KCl. Okay, so you will give the answer for KCN and CH3OH. Now next question is that question number 25. Between 2 molar glucose solution and 1 molar glucose solution, which one has lower freezing point? So students, depression in freezing point is directly proportional to the concentration of solute. We know that. Okay, so in which solute will be high, okay, or whose concentration will be high, this solution will freeze at lower temperature. So understand this question. Most of the students make a mistake in this question. So what is that? Depression in freezing point. Depression in freezing point is directly proportional to the molality or molarity or whatever concentration. Means jitni jada concentration hogi freezing point mein utni kami hogi lowering in freezing point. But mean which one will have the lower freezing point, 1 molar glucose or 2 molar glucose? So whose concentration is higher? 2 molar glucose. So 2 molar glucose will have the lower freezing point. But student, understand the question. Lower freezing point is asked. If it was the higher freezing point, then you will say 1 molar. But it was the question for lower freezing point, then 2 molar. But if suppose it is the question for boiling point, we know that elevation mean increment. Elevation in boiling point is directly proportional to the molality. Mean elevation higher kiska hoga? Then 2 molar. Okay, now increment, this colligative property is increment. But depression in freezing point, kami. Okay, so both depends on lowering in freezing point is directly proportional to molality. Similarly, elevation mean increment in boiling point is directly proportional to molality. For lowering, 1-2 molar glucose will have the lower boiling point. For elevation, then 2 molar glucose will have the higher boiling point. So understand this term carefully. If I am asking higher boiling point, then 2 molar. If I am asking lower freezing point, then it will also be 2 molar. Okay. Next question. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट, डिफ्रेंशिएट बिटवीन मोलैरिटी एंड मोलैलिटी ऑफ ए सोल्यूशन एंड वॉट इज द इफेक्टिंग चेंज इन द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द सोल्यूशन ऑन इट्स मोलैरिटी एंड मोलैलिटी. सो स्टूडेंट, दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन विच क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट, दिस वन. ओके, सो सिक्स्थ क्वेश्चन, ऑलरेडी वी हैव डन दिस क्वेश्चन. ओके, नाउ कम टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन, दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Arrange the following solution in increasing order of osmotic pressure. So student, pi, what is the formula of osmotic pressure? Pi is equal to I, concentration, R and temperature. Okay, so mean, for this solution, all will have the liter volume. Check this one, per liter. Okay, per liter mean, for concentration you will write mole per liter, so all have equal volume, and R will be same because it is constant and its value is 0.0821, mean R will also be same for all solution. Similarly, temperature will also be same because all are kept at same temperature. So pi, that is osmotic pressure, will depend only on the number of particle and the concentration of the solution. Okay, whose I into C will be high, their osmotic pressure will also be high. So students, we will just calculate I into C. Okay, now first is, I am making the space just here. Okay, first is 3.25 gram per liter sucrose. So first is 34.25 gram per liter. So concentration is mole per liter. What is concentration? Concentration is mole per liter. So liter is same for each. So I will just calculate the moles. Okay, so mole is given amount upon molecular mass. Molecular mass of sucrose is 342. Okay, so its mole are 0.1. Now come to second is 60 gram per liter urea. So amount is 60 and molecular weight is also 60 and its mole is 1. Now come to the third one is 90 gram liter of glucose. So amount of glucose is 90 and C6H12O6, that is glucose ka molecular mass hota 180 and its mole will be 0.5. and last fourth is NaCl and its amount is 58.5 and its molecular weight is also 58.5 and its moles is 1. Okay, so moles are 1. Now calculate pi is equal to ICRT. I is number of particles after dissociation. मैंने एक लाइव वीडियो बनाई थी, लाइव नहीं मतलब रिकॉर्डेड वीडियो थी, आप उसमें देखना, मैंने अच्छे से एक्सप्लेन किया. उसको नहीं करोगे तो ये चैप्टर होगा ही नहीं, मैंने पहले आपको बता दिया है. ओके, जनरली सुक्रोज इज ए नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, इट विल नॉट अंडरगो इन डिसोसिएशन और एसोसिएशन, सो इट्स आई विल बी 1. ओके, वो मैंने आपको लास्ट में अच्छे से बताया हुआ है, उस वीडियो को जरूर देखना स्टूडेंट्स, उसके बिना बात नहीं बनेगी. फिर भी अगर समझ में नहीं आ रहा तो मुझे कमेंट बॉक्स में लिखो, मैं दोबारा वीडियो बना के देने के लिए रेडी हूँ, लेकिन आप मुझे बताएं. ओके, पाई आई फॉर ग्लूकोज इज 1 एंड इट्स कंसेंट्रेशन इज 0.1, सो आंसर इज 0.1. ओके, नाउ फॉर यूरिया NH2CO NH2, इट्स आई अगेन, इट इज नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, इट्स आई विल बी 1 एंड 1 एट आंसर इज 1. ओके, सेकेंड इज ग्लूकोज इज ऑल्सो नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, इट्स नंबर ऑफ मोल्स आर 0.5, सो इट्स वैल्यू विल बी 0.5. बट स्टूडेंट, NaCl means sodium chloride is a ionic compound, it will dissociate into Na positive and Cl negative and it will give two ions. Okay, so I will be 2 and its number of moles is 1, so its value is 2. So now you will arrange in increasing order. I am writing first, second, third, fourth, na main ko arrange kar dunga. So increasing order of osmotic pressure. So least osmotic pressure will be this one. And this is what? First. Okay. First से ज़्यादा किसका होगा? First से ज़्यादा होगा 0.5. 0.5 कौन है? Third. Okay. Then third से ज़्यादा कौन होगा? One. That is second. Okay. And maximum will be for NaCl. And its number is 4. सो इट इज़ द इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. स्टूडेंट बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, इस बार CBSE ने भी इससे रिलेटेड एक क्वेश्चन पूछा था इसी टाइप का, मैं अभी आपको वो भी दिखा रहा हूँ, लेकिन पहले मुझे आप ये बता दीजिए ये आपको समझ में आ गया होगा. लेट्स सी व्हाट द CBSE आस्क्ड द क्वेश्चन. स्टूडेंट दिस इज द क्वेश्चन पेपर ऑफ CBSE क्लास 12th दिस ईयर. ओके सो यू कैन रीड ए अजर्सन रीजन टाइप इस क्वेश्चन. फर्स्ट टाइम CBSE यूज दिस कंसेप्ट. हेयर आर टू स्टेटमेंट assertion and reason. Okay, so assertion mean there is a statement and reason is the its explanation. Okay, so first read. Question is that 0.1 mole KCl has greater osmotic pressure than 0.1 molar glucose at the same temperature. So first of all you will tell the assertion is correct or not. So absolutely correct, because pi is equal to I into C into RT. So if R for KCl as well as for glucose it will be same, because ये तो constant है ना 0.0821, ये तो सब पर same रहेगा, and temperature is also same. So temperature is also same हो गया, तो so pi will depend on I into C. So student for KCl it will dissociate into K positive and Cl negative, so its I is 2 and concentration is 0.1, so its value is 0.2. but for glucose I is 1 and concentration is 0.1, so its pi will be 1. So absolutely correct. Some little bit disturbance student. So assertion is correct. Now come to the explanation. In solution KCl dissociates to produce more number of ion. बिल्कुल ठीक बात है, यही तो हम बात कर रहे हैं, ये टू पार्टिकल प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं. मीन बोथ ए एंड आर करेक्ट, एंड आर इज द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ ए, मीन आंसर विल बी ए. ये बच्चों ने आंसर लगाया होना चाहिए जो इस 7 मार्च को 2020 को बोर्ड एग्जाम में पेपर देकर आए CBSE वाले. बोथ assertion एंड रीजन आर करेक्ट, स्टेटमेंट एंड रीजन इज द करेक्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ assertion. Okay, so students, I hope you will enjoy this video. And from tomorrow, we will start some numerical. We will start from the osmotic pressure. Okay, bottom to top, we will discuss. Or whether we may start from the in a proper sequence, that is from the concentration term. Okay, so students, tomorrow we will start from question number 29. Okay, bye.